Today we're examining Batang, who is a female orang here at Smithsonian's National Zoo. She's about 14 and a half years old and weighs roughly 80 kilograms. We routinely examine our great apes, so our orangs, our gorillas, about every 2 to 3 years. And that exam is typically done under anesthesia. During that time, we do a full exam. We do a dental exam. We take blood and also collect urine for routine testing. And then as part of that exam, we'll also do radiographs or x-rays to look at their chest and their abdomen. We'll do an abdominal ultrasound. And then if they're due for any vaccines, we'll go ahead and perform those at that time. And then the other thing that we do is ask our veterinary cardiologist, a consulting veterinarian, to come in and do an echo, basically an ultrasound of the heart, to look for any evidence of heart disease. He takes a probe that's connected to that ultrasound machine and places it on the chest to look at the heart, at the different chambers, also at the valves of the heart. He'll take measurements of how big that heart is in each chamber and look at the function of those valves to make sure that blood is moving correctly from one chamber to the next. And then we're comparing those numbers to other values that we've recorded in other orangs and also gorillas, and creating kind of a database to look at all those numbers and say, is that normal, that abnormal? Sometimes we'll compare to human values, or if it's known, we compare for that species. Every day at the orangutan exhibit and enclosure, the keepers or the people that work with them on a day-to-day basis will give them a good look over. They'll look at how well they've been eating. They'll see how active they are. And then they give them different types of enrichment throughout the day, and that might be some type of physical activity, going outside, depending on temperature and weather conditions. They have feeder puzzles so that they don't just give them their food on a tray. It's more, how do you find that food? How do you get that food? And then there are a lot of cognition studies and different types of research going on at the area that involve looking at how those animals think. And that's a type of enrichment for them too. The keeper team is fantastic at reporting problems to us and really observing their animals every day. So they'll be the first ones to tell us if they notice a problem. It could be as simple as they're not eating or not drinking as normal, or they notice a wound. However, at the time of exam, we also look to see if there's any underlying health problems that you might not see at the naked eye.